This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Prime in association with Micromax.
Welcome, you're watching the South Special of the Property Show on NDTV Prime, a show that brings you best home choices in your budget. We have Sameer Jasuja, founder and MD of Prop Equity, to give you best options and suggestions to your property-related queries. And before we start with that, let's take a look at what we have for you in store today. Our top story today, Union Minister Venkaiah Naidu says government is on track and is confident of delivering 2 crore homes for the urban poor in the next 6 years as promised in its mission of housing for all by 2022. Top micro markets of Bengaluru to be covered for projects starting from a pocket-friendly 30 lakhs and going up to 1 crore. From top plotted development to top quality apartments that are worth your money in Hyderabad. Homes for self-use in 50 lakhs rupees in Coimbatore. As the government is ready with the smart city plan for Puneri in Chennai, we find out how it will impact the city's real estate landscape. In our experts segment today, we will tell you 5 things you need to know about EMI holidays. In Citizens Voice, a spotlight will be on a group of citizens in Bengaluru who are running a door-to-door campaign to make people aware about the need for garbage segregation. Our top story of the day, the Union Minister for Housing, Venkaiah Naidu, has said that he is confident of achieving the Housing for All target by 2022. In an exclusive tell-all interview with the NDTV's Vikram Chandra, the minister said that the government is on track with its affordable housing mission.
Affordable housing for all. Now that actually, Mr. Naidu, means, if my maths is not wrong, building something like 8,000 houses a day.
2 crore houses before 2022 in urban areas, 4 crore houses in the rural areas. That is the requirement.
So 8,000 houses a day, and that will, what is your plan? Is it going to take time to come up to that run rate?
I think now states are catching up. So again, you must understand here, land is a state subject. You cannot construct a house in air.
Yeah.
To construct a house on land. So land has to be identified. Earlier, what used to happen, project used to be sanctioned without identifying the land. Now the precondition is first you acquire the land, identify the land, show the land and send the proposal. 6,85,000 houses have been sanctioned in the first year. It shall show that the states are taking interest. There is demand now. Priority of the people's request is first house one. And then for that we have a multi-pronged strategy. Government alone cannot construct houses. So I am allowing private sector also. Private sector also is joining in a big way. You have seen the Real Estate Development and Regulation Bill, that will make the system more credible. Secondly, the private sector is playing a big role, you have seen across the country. I am constructing houses only for affordable housing, for weaker sections, for the economically backward people.
Yeah.
I am sure I will be able to reach my target. I am impressing on the states. Now there is a competition between the states and all. The Andhra Pradesh government identified the land. Send the proposal.
But land acquisition, you weren't able to get with the land acquisition bill not going through. Is it going to be tougher and tougher to acquire land for all of this?
It's going to be tougher and tougher, and the states and political parties should rethink on this issue. Many of the states, I can tell you, including Congress ruled states, they are in fear of land acquisition. Congress, for political reasons, have objected to that. Now that's why the suggestion came in the planning committee, Niti Aayog meeting. They leave it to the states. We are moving in the direction. And the states, people will be asking for a house, then land has to be shown.
So when you look at one of the main things that was projected by the Narendra Modi government, which was smart cities. Now a lot of people have this question: smart cities sounds like a very good idea. It's an ambitious idea, 100 smart cities. But when some of the basics are not yet sorted out in India's cities, traffic, look at the problems, waste generation, toilets, and all of that, is smart cities looking a bit too much in the future? That's what I'm not saying. That's a criticism that sometimes you hear people.
That thing wrong. That can be a view. But I must tell you, the smart cities are to act like lighthouses, so that people can draw inspiration. If there are better examples, good experiences, others try to follow. The Prime Minister wanted us initiative to start working on 100 cities, which will develop and then which will become livable in all walks of public life, improve the living standards of the people, create all the infrastructure and facilities so that they can act as lighthouses for others. This is catching up. The local bodies which were always looking up earlier, top to down, bottom approach, now bottom up approach is now followed. Every city is trying to improve. There is a competition.
So far, not much money has been spent on these smart cities. I think the budgetary allocation, some 7,000 crore rupees in 14, 15, nothing right now.
No. Each city is going to get 200 crores. Some of the cities, 20 odd cities, have already been given that money.
Okay.
So out of some, 20, 13 has been given money. Other 7 are has to do some information. That also will be done. First year, 20 cities. Second year, another 40 cities. Next third year, another 40 cities. The process is on. It took time, first of all, to explain what is smart city, how do you get finance, how do you reform yourself, how do you motivate the cities to accept this. Because cities were looking to district were looking to state were looking to center, and center has to look to World Bank or ADB.
Yeah.
That was the earlier this thing. Now it's changed that you have to raise your resources, number one. Secondly, you have to live up to the expectation of these people who want to invest. PPP model now has been allowed. 500 crores I am giving over 5-year period, that can be leveraged to get money from outside. My priority is housing for all.
Yeah.
So I am going to crash my target. 2 crore houses by 2022 will be made a reality.
And our focus will be upon Bengaluru, Hyderabad and Coimbatore property markets. We have our first caller with us. It's Sweetie Agarwal. Yes, go ahead with your question.
Oh, okay, hello, sir. I actually want to buy a 3 BHK apartment. It's Panasur Main Road in Bengaluru.
Mm-hmm.
And my budget is around 1 crore.
Okay.
And I have even shortlisted one property of HW Biltech named as Highcliff.
Okay.
So I wanted to know that is that property worth buying and your opinion.
Okay. So Sameer, what do you suggest on this?
Well, a couple of things that I'd like to say about this property. Highcliff is priced slightly higher on the higher side compared to the weighted average price of the market. That the reason for that is probably because it has an excellent location on Panathur Main Road and walkable distance to ORR. The bigger concern actually is that the project has been in pre-launch stage for a year now and all approvals are still not obtained. Developer has sent paper for bank finance, but no, there's no final confirmation on that yet as well. Developer is relatively new, so we would recommend you to avoid this project at this point in time. One doesn't know when the approvals will come, when the project will already start. So there are other projects that you can consider. Panathur has got 22 months of inventory overhang and we've got a much better micro market since your budget is very good for Panathur, which is Bengaluru, and a much better micro market that has an inventory overhang of 15 months. For the weighted average price of the mid to luxury segment, Panathur is at 4,600 rupees a square foot. And Bengaluru is at about 5,200 rupees a square foot. On the price appreciation charts, 10-odd% annualized appreciation for Panathur, and Bengaluru is about 7-odd% on an annualized basis. The two projects that you can consider are the Winter Green by Samruddhi Realty at 4,600 rupees spread across 3.25 acres. The project is 850 meters from Bengaluru railway station. Amenities here include clubhouse, swimming pool, indoor games, convenience stores, multi-purpose hall. And Sterling Essentia by Sterling Developers at 6,200 rupees, spread across 6 acres. Project is 2 kilometers from Sarjapur Road and 4 kilometers from Wipro Corporate Office. Amenities include a 36,000 square feet of garden space, swimming pool with deck, jogging track, clubhouse with sports facilities also are there.
So the options which you have in your budget are Winter Green by Samruddhi Realty, and the second option which you look into is Sterling Essentia by Sterling Developer. Next, we have Puneet Mitta joining us on the phone line. Yes, sir, how can we help you?
Yeah, hi. I would like to know about the PPL property in Hyderabad. My budget is 60 to 70 lakh and looking for a 3 BHK.
Okay.
Looking for your advice on the builder construction quality and appreciation about. Kindly please.
Okay. So, Sameer, he wants to know about the developer and the future prospects of this particular project.
Well, definitely, this is a very good project. You can go ahead with PBL City. The project is in phases and already about 500-odd families are staying in this project. Phase 1 is totally sold out and in Phase 2, the third and fourth towers are available. The project construction is being done by L&T. The total land area is 25 acres with 13 residential towers. The project is got good amount of amenities, including MediPlus pharmacy, besides a swimming pool, tennis court, clubhouse, and a gym, and many more amenities being there. Another micro market we've shortlisted for you. So Pirancheru has 11 months of inventory overhang, and Bengaluru has Guda has got 14 months of inventory overhang. The pricing is also pretty reasonable with respect to the weighted average price for these micro markets. Pirancheru is at 3,800 rupees and Bengaluru is at about 3,100 rupees. That's why the appreciation is also pretty reasonably good. Both micro markets are giving over a 9% annualized appreciation here. SMR Vinay Harmony County by SMR Holdings in Bengaluru at 3,400 rupees. This project has got many lifestyle amenities, children's area, swimming pool, tennis court, and many more. The project is coming up in two phases. It's a 10-acre project with G plus 13 stories. Then the third recommendation is Executive Park 2 by Giridhari Constructions in Bengaluru. This project is 3,100 rupees a square foot. It's having a land area of 9 odd acres. Amenities here are also fantastic, including a clubhouse, water harvesting pits, train model, play school, creche, RO plant, and many other facilities are being provided here.
So Mr. Puneet, your shortlisted option, which is PBEL City Phase 2 by PBBL, a property development private limited, gets a go ahead from our side. Other options which you can look into are SMR Vinay Harmony County by SMR Holdings and Executive Park 2 by Giridhari Constructions. Next is an email from Dharmendra Kumar, who is looking to invest in Bangalore. His budget is around 25 to 30 lakhs. He has a shortlisted Happy Living from Icon Homes near Electronic City. He wants to know if this is a good option or there are other projects available in this budget. So Sameer, what do you suggest? Good budget for this micro market?
Well, if you look at this project, it definitely gets a good go ahead from our side. Happy Living is a 5-acre project. Great amount of amenities. They're offering you about 8 to 10 amenities in this project, including a clubhouse, swimming pool, and many other facilities. The project is getting ready in different stages, few blocks in 4 months and remaining in end of 2016. The pricing is also pretty attractive, 3240 to 3360 rupees a square foot. It's an affordable segment project, so it's in line with the market, slightly expensive because it's a good project. The weighted average price of this market stands at 3000 rupees. The inventory overhang is safe at 23 odd months, and price appreciation is about 5.5% on an annualized basis. There are two more projects that you can consider: Purnima Elite by Purnima Biltech. This project is spread across 2 odd acres. Again, good amount of amenities. Ready by end of 2016. Currently, plastering work and flooring work is going on. It's located off Hosur Road in Anantnagar. Reputed corporates like TCS, Tech Mahindra, Infosys are in close proximity to this project. ABS Sunrise by ABS Builders and Developers at 2850, developed on less than 1 acre of land. Project will be ready by March 2017. Developers are providing few amenities like swimming pool, multipurpose hall, gym, clubhouse.
And so we're talking about Kamasandra, looks like a good micro market given the fact that it has good connectivity overall.
Yeah, absolutely. The upcoming Namba Metro is also going to help this area quite a bit in terms of connectivity. The micro market is having the Narayana Hidalaya Hospital, which is one of the world's biggest heart hospitals. Biocon is here, is diagonally opposite to the Electronic City and is 1 kilometer from the Electronic City Phase 2. So employment generation, social infrastructure, all there, and the metro also coming there, which will add more to this area.
So let me just sum up. It is a go-ahead for Happy Living by Icon Infra Shelters, which is your shortlisted option. Other projects which you can look into in your budget are Purnima Elite by Purnima Biltech, ABS Sunrise by ABS Builders and Developers. Now we have a caller. Senthil Kumar joins us on the phone line. Yes, how can we help you?
Yes, so I will be shifting to Coimbatore at the end of this year. And I'm looking for a 2 BHK with a budget of around 50 lakhs. In Sarvanampatti. Mm-hmm. So I was hoping you guys could help me suggest a project that would probably in the long run help me when it comes to appreciation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so first up, Sameer, how is Sarvanampatti as a micro market?
Well, Sarvanampatti as a micro market is a decent micro market. Don't expect too much appreciation out of this area, although it's an area which is close to the employment generation hubs, but the city in itself doesn't appreciate that much in terms of In terms of pricing, Coimbatore's latest IT corridor is where Sarvanampatti is there. It's 10 kilometers from the railway station, and airport is about 9 odd kilometers. It has both a tidal park and the KGSEZ. There are more than 30 colleges and various schools also located close to Sarvanampatti. Looking at the key data points, 26 months of inventory overhang, so sales are very slow. And there's a reasonable amount of supply. 3600 rupees a square foot is the weighted average price of the mid segment, and 6% is the annualized appreciation of this area. The projects that you can look at are Sri Daksha's Yaganya. This is Sri Daksha property developer, is the developer, having a land area of more than 1 acre. The amenities here include a gym, clubhouse, children's play area. Project will be ready by April 2017. The second project that you can look at is Oak Park by Vishwari Properties at 3200 rupees, having a land area of 1 acre. The project is ready to move. Amenities here include gym, community hall, children's play area, rainwater harvesting. And lastly, we have Shriram Sai Shriyas by Shriram Properties. It's a mixed development of apartments and villas. Total land area is 6 acres. Amenities are separate for villas and apartments over here. Total 17 banks have approved this project, so it's a good project. Clubhouse, gym, rainwater harvesting, indoor games are a part of the amenities of this project.
So plenty of amenities and plenty of options in this budget. Sri Daksha's Yagnya by Sri Daksha Property Developer is one option which you can look into. Oak Park by Vishwasri Properties is another, and Shriram Sai Shreyas by Shriram Properties is the third option which you have in your budget. Next, we have an email query from Prince Agarwal. He wants to buy a 2 BHK. He's looking for a property in 45 lakhs budget in the vicinity of Outer Ring Road from Mahadevpura to Kukurabi Sanahali. Which micro market should he go for?
Well, considering your budget, we are recommending you Marathali, which is in the Outer Ring Road. It's close to the employment generation zone of ORR. A lot of IT and SEZs are over there. Projects that we are recommending are all good developers and having good track records. Let's look at the key data points. 13 months of inventory overhang, 4600 rupees is the weighted average price for the mid segment, and 7.2% is the annualized appreciation. Oak Garden by Innovative Groups is the first recommendation at 3800 rupees, spread over 3 acres. The project construction is in finishing stages. Project is 1.7 kilometers from the Outer Ring Road. Amenities here include swimming pool, indoor games, amphitheater, cricket net, gym, rainwater harvesting. Sonesta Silver Oak by Nirman Sonesta Developers at 3450. It's having a land area of 2 acres with G plus 3 stories. It's a project ready to move in, and few families are staying here. Amenities here include clubhouse, gym, party hall, children's play area, and water softening plant, including a swimming pool. Eternity Astral by Eternity Structures at 3700 rupees. It's got a land area of 1 acre with G plus 3 stories. The project is located off Outer Ring Road on Panathur Road. The project will be completed by August 2016 and has amenities like the terrace swimming pool, multi-purpose hall, solar lighting and rainwater harvesting, besides a gym and 100% gen backup.
So Prince, the options which you have in your budget are Oak Garden by Innovative Groups, Sonesta Silver Oak by Nirman Sonesta Developers, and Eternity Astral by Eternity Structures. And all that you need to know about home loans is coming up next. And a new project launch, Prestige Lake Ridge by Prestige Group in Bengaluru.